Hi, this is Julie Harland, and I'm your math gal. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you could search for any of my videos organized by topic. This is part one of angles. It's an introduction, and on this video, we define several terms associated with angles, and we do four problems finding the complement or supplement of a given angle. We're going to start out with some basics about angles in general. So, a unit used to measure angles is the degree. And the symbol for degree is this little circle here, as in 30 degrees. And this symbol here, kind of looks like a less than symbol, is the symbol used for angle. Now, if you have, let's say, a line right here, and I want to do a full revolution, so I'm going to like go around all the way around here. One full revolution, which could be considered an angle, is actually 360 degrees. So one full revolution is 360 degrees. Now we could have angle of all sizes. We have what's called an acute angle. That would be it's less than 90 degrees. And an obtuse angle is between 90 degrees and 180 degrees. So, knowing this, it might be useful to think about where 90 degrees and where 180 degrees is. So, let's see. I just think of this plane here. If I go up all the way around, it's 360 degrees. Then, if I only go that far around, that should be 180 degrees. So, I could say this is a 180 degree angle right there. So, a 180 degree angle actually forms a straight line. So, we say a 180 degree angle is called a straight angle. Now, what about 90 degrees? Well, that would only be halfway up. So if I want to look at the 90 degree angle, it would be up through here. That would be 90 degrees. So we say 90 degrees is called a right angle. And the symbol we use for a right angle looks like this. Okay, it's kind of squared off because you could think of this right here. It's squared off, these are perpendicular lines, so that would be a right angle, 90 degrees. So looking back up, we've got going all the way around, one full revolution is 360 degrees. Halfway around, we get a straight angle, 180 degrees. Going a quarter of the way around, that's a right angle. And that would be 90 degrees. And then we also talked about an acute angle, less than 90 degrees, so it's somewhere smaller than this. It's a smaller angle. So, what would a picture of an acute angle be? It might look something like this. All right, kind of small. And what would an obtuse angle be? It would be bigger than this 90 degree, but not all the way over to here. So, an obtuse angle might look, let's see. Let's do this again. Might look something like this. That would be an obtuse angle, right? In between 90 and 180 degrees. So there's a lot of definition here, but you get used to it fairly quickly. Acute, less than 90, obtuse, bigger than 90, but still less than 180. And then we have the 90, 180, and 360, the right angle, the straight angle, and the full revolution. We just have a couple more words we're going to learn right now. Complementary and supplementary angles, and they have to do with the 90 or the 180 degree angle. All right, first let's define complementary angles. Complementary angles are two angles that add up to 90 degrees. So here's some examples. You think of two numbers that add up to 90 degrees. So 30 degrees and 60 degrees are complementary angles. Okay, what would be another example? What would it be if I had 10 degrees? What would the other angle be? Now keep in mind, the other angle, when added to 10 degrees, has to add up to 90. So what would that be? Well, that would have to be 80 degrees. And you can get that by doing 90 minus 10, for instance. 10 degrees and 80 degrees are also complementary angles. So it's just two angles that add up to 90 degrees. Next, we have supplementary angles. Supplementary angles are two angles that add up to 180 degrees. Okay, now the way I remembered these when I first learned them is in the alphabet, C becomes before S, so that's the 90 degree, and the supplementary would be the 180 degrees. Okay, whatever works for you. So, what are some examples of supplementary angles? Here's my abbreviation. Even though it's kind of funny to use an apostrophe, right? How about if I had 40 degrees and what would the other be? Okay, the two angles have to add up to 180 degrees, so if one's 40, what would the other one be? 140 degrees. Another possibility, how about 100 degrees and what would the other one be? 80 degrees. Now, what if I said, 56 degrees? You might not be able to do that in your head, but could you figure it out? Any ideas how do you figure out what the other one is? I would just subtract the 56 from 180 and see what you get. I think that's 124. And you could verify that is 56 plus 124. Does that add up to 180? And if so, then that would be correct. So those are examples of supplementary degrees. Okay, it's time for you to try a few problems on your own. So put the video on pause and try these four problems. All right, let's do number one. Find the complement of a 15-degree angle. So remember, the complement, well, complementary angles are two angles that add up to 90 degrees, so we have to think of what the other angle is that we could add to 15 to get 90. Now, you could use algebra to do this by thinking, well, the number I'm looking for, I'm going to call it C, and I know when I add it to 15, I would get 90. So you could make an equation up to figure this out, or some of you probably could figure that out in your head that it would be 75. But if you wrote it as an equation, we could write C plus 15 is 90. And when you subtract 15 from both sides, you'll get 75. But of course, this is an equation you made up. We're not just solving an equation. What's the complement? Our answer will be in degrees, 75 degrees. So, not necessary to write an equation, but it's certainly okay to do it. And some people may just figure what they have to add to 15 to get 90. Some may actually get out a piece of paper and do 90 minus 15 to get 75, and some people will write an equation and solve the equation. Either way is fine. Any of those ways. How about number two? Find the supplement of a 15-degree angle. All right, so now we want to find an angle that's a supplement of 15. So again, if you wanted to write an equation, you can. Let's say I call it x. When I add 15, I would get 180 degrees. Actually, I'm just going to write 180 and not worry about the degrees till later. So what would that be? If I subtract 15, it'd be 165. And so we'd have 165 degrees. That would be the supplement. Now you can always check your answer by adding the two angles. Is 15 plus 75 90? That would be the answer for number one. And is 165 plus 15 equal to 180? Yes, then they're supplementary angles. All right, number three. Find the complement of a 71-degree angle. Again, up to you if you want to write an equation. We could call it C plus 71 equals 90. And when you subtract 71, you get 19. So my answer here would be 19 degrees. And again, you would verify that. 71 plus 19 equals 90. And the last one, find the supplement of 120 degree angle. This one's pretty easy to do in your head. What do you add to 120 to get to 180? That would just be 60 degrees. So remember, using equations can be helpful to find the answer to a problem. This isn't asking you to write an equation. It just asks you to find the complement or the supplement of any angle. And so however you figure it out would be fine, but you could write an equation. That's what's cool about algebra. Sometimes equations make it easier for some people to find the answer. On the next video, Angles 2, we'll do more problems where using algebra to find the answer will be useful. And you probably will need to use algebra in many of these cases. Please visit my website at yourmathgal.com, where you can view all of my videos, which are organized by topic.